Today we are going to see two interesting topics. Allegation by an independent director against a listed company and the company's counter allegation against independent director. Mr. Aravind Gupta was an independent director in Agash Optic Fiber Limited, New Delhi. He resigned from this position of the independent director of the company with resignation letter dated 5th September 2020 with immediate effect. In his resignation letter, he alleged that promoters were guilty of non-disclosure of RTP dealings, thereby siphoning of public funds. Board committee members, KMPs and auditors involved in financial fraud by writing off rupees 339 crores from the books of accounts, thereby committing serious frauds. He alleged that there were distressing governance lapses and mischievous secretarial practice shielding promoters, which constituted a major reason for his resignation as independent director. He alleged that there were non-disclosure of RTPs benefiting promoters, non-transparent RTP transaction with the overseas subsidiaries, the AOL, FSZE, UAE, Akash Optic Fiber Limited, UAE, and overseas step-down subsidiaries of Akash Optic Fiber conducting business with the promoters. He further alleged that promoters RTPs with Africa One Telecom Limited and Electrum Telecom Group of Companies were prejudicial to the interest of the shareholders of the Indian company. In response to the complaint by the independent director, it was submitted by the management of Akash Fiber that as per the directions of the Stakeholders Relationship Committee, an independent external auditor was appointed to check the records and provide its report on the allegation of RTPs by independent director. Pursuant to the extensive audit conducted by the independent external auditors, they submitted their report before Stakeholders Committee meeting on 3rd July 2020. Stakeholders Relationship Committee, consisting of four independent directors on the board of the company, adopted the report of the independent external auditor and concluded that none of the alleged related company, total 13 related to company or its directors, company and its earlier or current directors are in compliance of law. The related party allegations are baseless. It was alleged by the company that resigned ID independent director Aravind Gupta entered a consultancy agreement on 13th May 2019 with the company to help the company to recover the dues of rupees 73 crores from BSNL outstanding. As no payment was received from BSNL as assured by Aravind Gupta, no commission was paid to him and the above agreement expired on 31st May 2019. Mr. Aravind Gupta, as an independent director, he promised that he knows some top people in BSNL and tried to help the company to get their outstandings of 73 crore, but he could not do that and that's why the company did not pay him any commission. Company also alleged that Aravind Gupta had purchased 10,000 shares of the company during third week of June 2019. Company also alleged that proposal was moved in the nomination remuneration committee to appoint Mr. Aravind Gupta as director and professional consultant at a fee of rupees 10 lakh per month. Fortunately, the proposed resolution was not passed by the committee. So, Aravind Gupta also, who was holding 80,000 equity shares of the company when he was appointed as a ID in the company, and in the March 2020, he bought 110,000 shares of the company, and as of March 2020, he had 190,000 equity shares of the company. This is also against of the norms of the LODR. Members discussed about the insider trading regulations and the provisions and express concerns on purchase of shares after becoming ID independent director. Company had noticed that post the meeting Post the meeting of Share of Stakeholders Relationship Committee, which happened on 3rd July 2003, for adoption of external auditor report and expressing concern about the other independent directors of the company by Arvind Gupta on 4th July 2020, the next day after the Stakeholders Relationship Committee meeting. Here, the alleged complaints of Mr. Arvind Gupta has been released in the media for the reason best known to Mr. Arvind Gupta and the media. So, the company alleged that the independent director had acted against the provisions of the insider trading and he purchased the shares of the company while he was independent director without informing to the company, and also he was against the resolution which was not passed for paying him rupees 10 lakh rupees as consultation rupee for every month. So this is a very good case law where an independent director alleges against a company and the company in turn alleges against the. So this is very very interesting case, and this is deserves to be interrogated by the high level authority, by the MCA, by appointing a fraud investigation against the company. The next topic is, from 1st October 2020 onwards, retiring employees will get pension from EPFO on the day of their retirement. EPFO gives big relief to private employees will get the as they will get benefit of this new facility from 30th September 2020. There is a good news for the employees working in private sector. Now EPFO has taken better initiative protect the future of these employees in this scheme. Wherever, whichever employee retires on that day, the pension will be ready from the same day and will be started. This arrangement is considered to be a big change for the employees, as it usually takes months for the government or private employees to get an arranged pension after retirement. True, because I retired from a company last 2 years back and still I am fighting with the EPFO office to get my pension. They have made so many queries. I replied with the evidence and everything. Now it is not, even after 2 years, they have not yet cleared my pension. This is a very pathetic situation which the employees, retired employees, are facing today. And this scheme will help these employees to get the pension on the day of their retirement. The paper goes on for a long time, and after the complicated exercise, the pensioner's order is formed. But now this will not happen. Now the employer will get the benefit immediately after the employees who retire on after 30th September 2020. They will receive all the documents related to their pension on the same day. 30 seconds. So friends, if you like this video, please I request you to subscribe my channel. For thanking you once again for watching this video, RV Shagar, practicing company secretary.